It's only one way to start.
Four defenders that have performed at VVD's level is Rio, John Terry, and Vidic.
I mean, how long are we going to act like this guy's a top striker, man?
Champions League final.
We got to the Champions League final and lost to Liverpool. I've accepted
cool
that and moved
that.
On.
Worst week ever as a Spurs fan.
I think the most pertinent issue that we can discuss, and I've said that I'm not.
That loves a big word.
That's the dumbest thing you've said on this pod. You just said Spurs are in turmoil. You know you want to say it. Don't let him press you.
Welcome back to another episode of Stoppage Time TV. We're live, back in the flesh, live and direct. Direct in effect. You already know what time it is. Why the man them laughing at the intro, bro? What's going on?
Man them moving like shy girls on a date.
Before we go any further, make sure you're subscribed. Make sure notifications are switched on. And as we're going into this new lockdown, take your time to go back and watch previous episodes. You know, and entertain yourselves. Like, listen, there's a lot of good stuff there. There's a lot of heat. Skip the Zoom error. Just before the Zoom. Just
hey, there's a couple interviews in there though. Some little ones.
Yeah. But I'm talking about the Zoom error where Cam sounded like he was in like a turbine or something.
Fucking Al Qaeda. But go on.
Anyway, without further ado, we have to get into the show. And there's only one place to start. So
all tight.
Without any further ado,
tell me I'm lying. I ain't lying. I'm sorry, man.
under, there was no duress.
Hey, that's funny. Still,
loosen up your jacket, man. You're coming hot, bro. Man. No. You don't have to make every shot, bro.
I like it. I need to be cozy.
So listen, the shot clock's dead. You have to make every shot. Listen,
shoot.
Without further ado, wait, hold on. Without further ado, hold tight. The 3-point collectors. Hold tight, the participants. And hold tight everyone else, and hold tight the man inside and all that as well. But listen, let's get into the TL Clasico, as I've dubbed it. What's your thoughts on this game? Very interesting one. Last week we had our thoughts on Arteta and said that how honeymoon period is over,
mm-hmm.
which is fair to say. Ironically, on the other side of it, you have Ole, who's had, you know, some mixed results recently. Some headline ones have been great. Of course, the 6-1 is not too distant memory. And he's coming into his 100th game. That's what I'm saying. He's coming into his 100th game.
Yeah.
And no matter what, whether the quality is out of the window, no matter whether the players are not the standard that we used to think they were in this little fixture, this is one of the biggest fixtures in the Premier League. So there's certain things you expect. And yeah, on that note, what did we think about the game? What's our thoughts? Any key bits of information that we learned? What are we saying?
I'll let the United man go first. Sure, he's got something.
You know what? Yeah, it was one of them ones where it's like, the thing is, look, first and foremost, no matter what you say about Big Sam Teta, Mikel Arteta, no matter what you say about him,
slick.
he's better than Ollie. He's a better manager than Ollie.
Yeah.
And I've had arguments about this with United fans. And I remember when we beat Leipzig, just the other day we beat Leipzig. And then there were people were like, oh, so what are you saying about blah, blah. And I'm like, he's still a better coach to me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Will Arsenal fans, listen, the thing is, will Arsenal fans be happy with the way they turned up to Old Trafford? I don't know. That's for them to answer. Because mm-hmm. for me, still defensive. And again, it's one of them ones where it's like, if you win, you're happy. I know next week you're going to be complaining. Yeah. But right now, they got the bragging rights and stuff. So that's fair enough. But my thing is, I look at Man United and it's just like, again, it's the same thing. And I said, the one thing that you get with Man United is the consistent thing you get with Man United is inconsistency.
Consistently
that's
inconsistent.
What you, yeah, consistently inconsistent. Yeah. 1 week, you're up here. Next week, back down there. It's literally like this. There's no
roller
medium.
Coaster.
There's no medium. There's no like, at least just, you know, coast. We can't coast. No. Right now, like Spurs are just, you know, getting on coasting right now. Mm. United, boom, 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 boom.
We've had a few.
Yeah,
that's how I see it. Like, you're on cloud nine with PSG. You're at the bottom with Chelsea. Even though it's 0-0, it's dead. Then you go Leipzig, smash them. Oh my days, what a performance. Then you go and produce that against. Listen, like when I've said it time and time and time again. I'm not even Ollie's not good enough for Man United. Look, it's as simple as that. And I said, look, 100 games. Now it's 100, and I said this is why it's perfect. 100 is a landmark. So it's a milestone. It's a
monument. Yeah.
It's a milestone.
Yeah.
If after 100 games, any United fan still think that Ollie's good enough, then you need to give your head a wobble.
Yeah.
You need to give your head a wobble. And I've said it many, many times. The guy is not good enough.
Do you think then he's set up tactically?
Man United set up with a diamond.
Yeah. Because I thought it was the first time you lot started with a diamond. And that's what I feel like every United fan has been called for.
Do you know what's mad? No, we did it against Leipzig and it worked. Yeah. We set up on a diamond to do counter-attack. How does that make sense? How can you be in a diamond and play counter?
I like where we're going with this because there's so many conversations for me that come out of this game. And I think before we even go further, the show, one thing, and we don't do it anyway, I believe anyway, but a lot of football fans as fanatics get stuck in the moment. So they analyse one game and hold it like that.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to look at things in totality of where we are in the season and everything. And one thing I've understood from Ollie and his time there is he would change formation here, then everywhere because he hasn't got the tactics or the game management to kind of make a plan come to life.
Ollie so stumbles change, into things.
Yeah, so you can change your formation as much as you want to.
Yeah.
But if you haven't got a game plan to go over formation or something, it's pointless. Like you said, if you've done a diamond and then you want to counterattack, how is that going to benefit if you haven't got a fullback that can give you anything?
Why do you want to counterattack against Arsenal who were there for the taking?
Back five.
I was looking at Arsenal and I was like, this is the best that they can offer.
Yeah.
Arsenal playing to the best of their ability and it was nothing. You look at Man United and you think you've got another gear to go up. You ever been out, yeah? Have you ever been out on a night out and then the club finishes and then you're just waved with your boys and you just see one other club and you just, walk into that club.
Yeah.
And it was actually lit and you're like, oh.
Yeah.
And then you go there next week and it's like, oh, this club's actually dead.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what Ollie does. He stumbles into formations. Thing, he stumbles into things and thinks, oh, yeah, I can do, oh, that worked. But no, he changed it. The diamond that worked against Leipzig had Matic at the base and it had Van de Beek on. You hook Van de Beek again and you bring him on when we're losing. Listen, now, depth is calm, depth or whatever, but it's going to look silly if you flip and keep losing without him on the pitch.
And you're not using.
We've scored not that many goals, about 9 goals that we've scored this season. Van de Beek has been on the pitch.
I think that was probably your biggest issue as well. Was every time you were trying to go through your midfield, Fred and McTom were doing the exact same thing.
It was almost going nowhere.
Every time you knew they got the ball, and your fullbacks as well. You've got Aaron Wan-Bissaka and Luke Shaw, who are meant to be your natural width.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel like they were offering you any.
What have I said about attacking fullbacks?
100%
attacking fullbacks.
It comes back to that as well. And for me, it's Van de Beek. I feel like every time I've seen him play, he has an influence on the team. The diamond, I feel like you would only really play that if you're going to sock him in.
And
when he doesn't play, I'm just like,
what's the point of
it? That comes to your tactical
management. Again, it's one thing to throw formation. It's another thing to actually
to coach
my,
it.
My whole thing, I always say this year is, with footballers, I will never understand why managers don't put their best players in best positions, or even if not best players, accommodate your players into things that suit them. When you looked at that team that went out today against Arsenal, you look at it and you think to yourself, are you really accommodating everyone here? Are you really doing the best for everyone in this team? And then you look at your position and you look at what Partey is doing in the midfield against your midfield, you start going, okay,
we're going to talk about that.
Like,
but do you know what it is?
Funny.
When I look at it, right? When I look at what Ollie did, right? The diamond, I've got no problem with a diamond. That's my thing. I've got no problem with a diamond, right? But it's the manner in which it's done. McTominay, I don't know what role he was playing today. Fred might as well have put on an Arsenal top because he was passing to Arsenal as if that was his boys.
Yeah.
Honestly, I thought he played for Arsenal today.
What did Benzema say to Vinicius?
Yeah, yeah, literally.
Hey, bro, don't pass to him.
Please. He's against us. Bro, honestly, Fred was against us today. Hey, like, he was passing to opposition.
McTominay.
A young Akron, you know.
Bro, McTominay, I don't know what he was doing as well. But listen, Ollie set up in terms of his tactics, not the formation. I think the formation was right. The setup was wrong.
That's the thing.
Bruno was playing.
It's in the details.
This is what I mean about Bruno. He was playing like a striker. Bruno, you are a midfielder, for goodness sake, bro. You think you're he thinks it's Firmino, isn't it?
He's centre forward.
You're not.
He was literally trying to play between Rashford and Greenwood.
I'm not going to repeat the same point, but it goes to stand. If you've got a manager that can take someone and say, listen, in terms of what I want to do and what we need to do as a team, you can't do that. You might see a different Bruno. The thing is,
that's facts.
We have to address the elephant in the room. We've always said it. He is always going to play this high risk, high reward where I'm going to shoot from 30 yards. I'm going to do all these spectacular passes.
Quickly, but before you finish that,
yeah,
he doesn't do that for Portugal.
But why?
This is what I'm saying.
Management.
But this is what I'm saying. So we're saying this Ronaldo. Is... What, no, no, this
That's the truth.
we're saying this is Bruno. But why does he not do that at Portugal? Because he's got someone to possibly be like, yo, what are you doing?
Relax yourself.
Relax. And he plays a little bit deeper for Portugal. I don't understand where Bruno thinks he can play this striker.
Do you know what it is? Because since he came in, he's saved you lot on so many occasions.
I mean. And now it's almost
like, did you see him when he got the captain's arm, man? I went, it's been due, you know? It's been due.
He's been giving me everything.
Hey, I'm telling you.
Captain in under 6 months. But listen.
But here's the thing. As much as I would say we should bash United, I think Arsenal, you got to give them some credit as well. And I only say in their midfield especially, because that was where your strength, I thought, was going to be today, where you outnumbered them 4-2.
Yeah.
And I thought the two best players on the pitch were easily, well, Gabriel as well. But Elneny and Partey, I thought, dominated that midfield. It was meant to be Pogba v Partey or whatever.
Manchester United made Elneny and Partey look like
Petit Vieira.
Elneny looked like Petit, bro.
And I saw Arsenal fans tweeting before the game, like, how is Elneny finessing his way onto the starting lineup? What? So there's people still questioning why, but I've seen a couple of performances this season where he's actually done okay.
But to be fair, last week we spoke about Xhaka, but Elneny's been one of these guys that Arteta brought back.
Elneny, if I come on.
You know we would kill him.
Yeah, exactly.
You know,
apologies.
But he did that last week, apologies. And we play a blind eye to it.
Apologies.
I'm not gonna say no.
But he's been brought back from. He's brought back by Arteta. Remember, he was in the wilderness.
Don't kill me.
They thought he was gonna get sold. Brought him back, and he's come back now, despite what everyone said, and he's seemingly getting better.
I was talking like Elneny's moving like Zidane.
No. Partey was the one I thought. Like Partey for me and Gabriel were the two I thought.
Listen,
Partey's doing what
Gabriel since he's come in. I think every game he's put a minimum of a 7.
Who?
I haven't seen him have a bad game yet.
What a signing!
Like absolute quality signing.
We were linked and we slept. We slept.
Another one bites the dust.
Listen, you see, when it comes to Partey. When I look at Partey, right?
People have been asking what you did a dance to this week.
Dude, you know, have you seen that meme of that little kid where he's crying? Yeah.
That
would be me doing it. But people talk about, when you look at Partey, right? When I look at him, that's world class, bro. That's a world class midfielder, bro. Like, in that DM role, he was making tackles. He was intercepting. Not even
starting attacks.
He was starting attacks. And it's not even that, bro. The guy will get the ball, pass it. Doesn't admire his pass. I want it back.
Yeah.
Gonna get it. Pass it again. I want it back.
He's telling next man where to pass it.
He'll get the ball. Bro, one time I saw him get the ball, he passed it, ran into the box, acted like he ran into the box, then and just dropped. Just received it.
Yeah.
You know our midfielders were about 6 yards away.
You know what the biggest quote?
That's brain. That's
the biggest compliment you can give someone at Partey is, you know, in this new generation where someone's like, oh, I'm an attacking mid, I'm a midfield winger, I'm a DM, I'm a DLP. He's just bread and butter. I do everything. I go forward,
bro,
go back.
They keep trying
to pass, I intercept, I tackle.
Bro, he's world class.
British pundits as well keep talking about, he's physical, he's strong in attack. Yeah. Bro, he's more than that. He's more than that. Do not sleep on his tech. This guy has got technique and ability, fam. Yeah.
I'm sorry. He totally, Man United on the other hand, Man United will say we have a world class midfielder in Pogba. Yeah,
bro.
He totally embarrassed.
He told man, you're dismissed to the left wing. You're banished from midfield.
When I look at it, like you, when I look at the
bro,
two, no, on a real, but when he I look dashed. At the two teams, when I look at the two teams, and I look at who's a world class player in this team, Partey is the one. When I look at Pogba, I'm not saying that at the moment, and I'm not. And the thing is, look, and I've mentioned it before. People, some reason, if I talk about Pogba, I'm racist when I'm black, but we move anyway. So when you look at Pogba, right? I've mentioned it earlier in the season. You've been at a club for five seasons.
Time to deliver.
What did I say? I actually said time to deliver. We need at least player of the year form. I didn't say win player of the year. I said player of the year
we
form.
We need that level of performance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This brother has played worse than he's ever played for Man United. He is honestly a disgrace at the moment. And when I'm looking at him, like every match Pogba started this season, we've lost. four gate starts, four losses. He's actually not playing to the level.
Riddle me this. So in the co-commentary, Neville came out, right? And he essentially said, the question was asked to him, is there so much pressure on him to perform? And what he said
what
was...
What the hell does that mean?
So, and that, but no, let me just give you the quote. He said, essentially, for nearly word for word, he said, the way he looks at it is, the pressure that comes onto Pogba is very similar to that came onto Gerrard during his time at Liverpool when they weren't winning anything.
I agree.
What's your views on that?
Listen, I've always been one to say, don't compare Paul Pogba to Gerrard. People will talk about, Pogba has won the Serie A and stuff. Listen, I've got a news flash for everybody. Juventus have won the league every single season since Pogba's been gone. Juventus will win the league if Ronaldo leaves. Juventus will win the league without Pirlo. They'll win the league without Tevez. They'll win the league every single season. All right, when you talk about, for example, Cristiano Ronaldo going to Juventus, people will say, oh, that's a dead move because Juventus win the league every year.
Mm.
So why do you use that to hold Pogba to the high heavens? Because ever since he's been in the Premier League for five seasons, I ain't seen enough. People will talk about 18, 19 when he got in the team of the year after an 8-game run and then packed his bags.
Too many times this season we've seen too many people say this is his worst game so far.
It's like now you're actually costing us football matches, bro. To give away a penalty like that, then come out and say, you know what, it's because of the run that I had to make, I'm a bit tired or whatever.
Do you know how many times he lost the ball that game?
That's how many times?
12.
12 times?
12 times. He was involved in 15 duels. Guess how many he won?
How many?
Four. Fam, he got absolutely bullied. This
is
what I'm
saying. Bro, no, honestly, the excuse has always been, oh,
he hasn't got a DM next to him.
He needs to play in the left side of a three. He needs to do this. We have done every single... We've given him workhorses behind him. We've given him players that pass the ball fast. We've put him in a pivot. We put him as 10 before.
Yeah, I've
we
seen
put him
that,
on the
yeah.
left wing. Fam, what is this? And the thing is, I understand Ollie's not a good manager, but we blame Jose. We blame him. Mm. And the thing is, it's an 8-game tournament. Everyone's going to talk about the World Cup. And this is what I don't like about United fans. And I'm a United fan, but this is what I don't like. When it was time to do key at Mesut Ozil, and Arsenal fans would just bring up the picture of him with the World Cup and be like, boom, United fans would be like, what did he do for Arsenal though? But now when you talk about Pogba,
the shoes on the
you
other
bring,
foot.
Oh, no, it's because he had Kante next to him. He's got... So what? The environment has to be perfect for him.
Yeah.
With the same mouth Man United fans would use to diss Steven Gerrard, yeah? When he was playing with Schmitzer and all these joke men.
Ronan.
You'd use to hype. But it doesn't make sense. Yeah. Like,
is it back to the bench for him now?
For me, it's like, how can you be getting benched for Manchester United with this team? How can you do that? It baffles me.
But when you put performances like that in big games as well, where you're supposed
to
turn up.
I'm telling you now, it's absolutely no sweat off my nose.
You
if Pogba,
even in your big wins in the Champions League this season, I wouldn't say he's kind of been like a big
he
part
was very
of that.
Good against Leipzig. I'll give him that. He was off the bench against PSG, so he wasn't. Leipzig, he got the assist. He was good. But the thing about Pogba is, again, he's like the football version of Ollie. One week you're gonna get Pogba, like, yeah. Next week you're like, oh my days, you're dropping a zero out of 10.
Yeah.
I've mentioned before, there should be no occasion on a football pitch that I look at Pogba next to Fred, McTominay, or whoever, and you're worse than them.
That shouldn't be happening. As a United fan, after this year, would you say his time at England is completely a failure?
Yeah. For me, Pogba's time at Man United. Yeah, for me, Pogba's time at Man United will be deemed a flop. If Man United, let's say we have just the average season, don't make the Champions League or whatever. Even if we make the Champions League, we don't win silverware or whatever.
Yeah.
We don't win a Premier League. He's Pogba's time at Man United will be deemed as a flop. Yeah. We have to be real. He came to Man United as a world record fee. It has not worked out. Stop hanging on to the 18-19 team of the year because he turned up for 8-9 games and then we were shocking for the rest of Ollie's reign. Everyone turned up. Rashford turned into Ronaldinho. Everyone was on it. Then they packed their bags, went on holiday, and we started going on historic losing runs.
Yeah,
we have to be honest honest here. I don't care about, there's too many Pogba fanboys. There's too many people that are blinded. They want to blame Souness. They want to blame this. They want to blame the Daily Mail. They want to blame the Sun. Listen, at the end of the day, you got to perform on the football pitch. I'm not defending what Daily Mail do. I'm not defending none of that, but you got to perform on the football pitch, and he doesn't do it.
For me as well, like I've always said, like it's one thing to have ability, but without application, we're just talking for the sake of talking.
We're just talking. We're literally just talking. Facts. When I look at, bro, when you look at the top midfielders, right, they do it. This is what I've always said about Pogba. And the thing is, it's funny because I've been about this since Juventus, like about Pogba in terms of how he is. He's a highlight player. Pogba can give you, I can show you so many videos of Pogba doing something crazy. You send it to your boy, I'll send it to my boy. And you're like, do you think he's the greatest player of all time?
Yeah.
You don't send videos like that about Modric. You don't send videos about Cruz because they just do it week in, week out. They're just doing their job every time, consistently. But Pogba is one of them guys who, he might not do something three games. That fourth game, flipping out, he might control the ball in the air and do a mad thing because his ability is unbelievable. But how long can you rely on that?
But it's funny because you've got that and you've got Bruno and then you've got, when you put all these pieces together. But for me, when we're just looking at the game,
I don't want to make it, just the last thing. I don't want to make it like it's all Paul Pogba.
No, right?
It's not all Paul
Pogba. That's what I want
to
segue
to. We were shocking today. Yeah. Ollie needs to get the hell out of the club. Right, Arteta schooled him yet again. This is the second time he schooled him. Last time he did it through attacking football. Ozil was like moving like Real Madrid Ozil, and then now this time they did it through defensive football. Either way, they schooled him twice now, and it was all round. It was poor from every player, not just Paul Pogba. I'm only talking about Pogba because I expect more from him. Yeah. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
But what I wanted to segue onto was this is their first win against Big Six since 2015. Am I right?
The first away win. This ain't their first away win in
2015.
God knows how long, bro.
It's their first win at Old Trafford for 15 years.
Yeah, that's right. 2015, right? I'm pretty sure it's
production don't know, man.
It's all mad.
No, production don't know.
For me, either way, we were saying before the game, if United had needed any motivation, the news that came out about
Sir Bobby Brown. How can you do this on Sir Bobby? I feel like slapping every single player.
And Nobby Styles.
Two huge legends of the club. Yeah.
Hang your heads in fucking shape.
That's Nobby's number.
Hey!
I'll allow that one. That's disgrace! The guy behind me like, Souness, isn't it? No, that's disgraceful.
For football as well, right? Performances can be bad, yeah? But effort. Effort is that. That has to be key. And for me, that's not always about what the manager does, you know? You got to look at the individuals. And don't get me wrong, like, Ole said some criminal stuff. Remember when he said against Chelsea, oh, if the Stretford end with him, maybe we'll get a bit of push and everything.
Did it again.
And I thought, bro, you can't always be saying this because you should have enough motivation in a big game like this to make your team go out there. This team has not won away to a Big Six team for 5 years. And now you're the first ones that they've come and done it against. Like, what's that going to leave in terms of feeling your changing room?
Sorry to mention,
your home form is, I don't care whether it's fans or not, that's the fair of dreams, right? You man are making
theater of dreams, bro. They all must have Freddy Krueger in their head because we've got nightmares out there, bro.
It's ridiculous. Every single point you're dropping. Have you?
We haven't won at Old
Trafford.
We've lost three games. How many games have we played? Six.
You lost to Palace, you lost to us.
Yeah, we've lost three games at Old Trafford this season. Yeah. And we drew against Chelsea. We played six games. We've lost 50% of our matches. And we've lost I don't know what the ratio will be, but we've lost nearly all of our home games.
Listen.
He has turned Old Trafford into a joke. And look, and this is one thing. Ollie, what was the word you used? You said camaraderie, right, last week?
Camaraderie.
Yeah, he's one of them players, right? No, Ollie's one of them. Ollie's one of them managers who, he loves talking about the Stretford end and when I was in my day and
the spirit,
the Fergie time, and he likes all that. So if he likes tradition so much, does he not know that Old Trafford was a fortress? How the hell has he made it a place where people can just come and dump on?
Come like Powley, bro.
He has been the BGB, as you call them.
He has, but not Old Trafford.
They were the BGBs before today.
But what I don't get is, why is it only Stretford End, or whatever he wants to talk about, an issue now? After lockdown, when we were winning at home, why didn't he mention no fans?
Hey, it's always the way it is. He knows he's out of his depth.
I'm telling you, every single day, like what Van der Vaart said about Maguire, every single day, Ollie must.
You thought he was good?
He must go home and say to his wife, "We've done it again." Like, I'm still the manager.
We could be
honestly,
we could be here all day, but not a good result.
But we got a bigger Arsenal.
Yeah, yeah, of course, Arsenal deserve respect. Like you said, whether the fans like the football or not, you.
They created some chances, some half chances in the first half. I thought in the second half they were getting better.
For me, it's improvement. And again, like I mentioned with the Lampard thing, right? When you've got games coming in thick and fast and everything, I understand why it's going to be hard for so many managers this year, because each week, if you get injured, you're changing your personnel each week.
Yeah.
There's certain things that you want to do for game to game that you're not even going to have time to tell, man, listen, we need to do this and that. So his base throughout his whole time, his tenure has been, we are going to be defensively sound. I don't care whether you like it. I don't care whether your granddad hates it. I don't care.
As long as we're getting something.
Remember, we praised him initially and said 1-0 to the Arsenal was the old school way. So I don't want to take away from him from that. But the key thing is you have to add that technical element. And today I feel like they did try and create chances.
No, they did.
That's what I said.
And it's about building.
Aubameyang had a chance.
My thing about Arteta's spin is in every game, they're not going to be able to kind of sit back and counter. So when they are flowing and playing good football, that's what they need to have as well. You can't just be one kind of counter-attacking system like we tried that. It doesn't work. You have to attack and go forward and actually be flexible.
Develops and again, where other players
you can't have
know.
Like your A plan, but there's always
got to be a B plan.
Yeah, 100%.
Like we said, that comes with the progression of managers in terms of how good they are and whatnot. And it's a perfect segue.
Arteta's smart, I'll give him that.
Yeah, like I said, after the Chelsea 2-1 result and beat them, people like this, you've got to bat because it's clear that they have a plan. Like, you wouldn't look at Arteta and think he hasn't got a plan. He's at least sticking to what he knows and trying to do something. You may not like it, but if they were to win another FA Cup, they wouldn't complain.
As and I said,
what they're supposed to achieve. So,
give Arteta 100 games. Let's see where Arsenal are, because... Yeah, I mean, we've gave Ollie 100 games and look at us, we're 16th. Brighton lost, so we're 15th, thank God.
Let's go to the Chelsea game.
Thank us.
Yeah.
But thank God.
We move.
We'll touch on against that as well. Let's go to the Chelsea game. So 3-0 against Burnley. Against a Burnley that's not the Burnley we know it to be. Against a Burnley that's made no signings.
Not the Burnley we played Monday.
I think Burnley are
Listen,
going
they were fighting us on Monday.
No, of course. But again, I think that's Sean Dash trying to look up to his older, isn't it? Like, I'm you. But in terms of this game, I'll give my thoughts. But what did you guys think? What do you guys think of Chelsea's form at the moment? Do you think that this is a turning, or do you reckon it's just a passage they're going through?
I think you're on a good spell of form, but I think this has probably been your most cohesive performance, I would say, under
I'm
Lamps.
Glad you said that, because it's the first time that all six of the new signings have started all together.
That I heard that as well. And then I think like even your centre-back pairing now, it's the first time they've kind of... It hasn't changed for four games or something like that. And I'm like, when you have that consistency of power, we always just say, Lamps is very reactionary. He loses one game or drops points and he's like... Fuck it, I'm switching it all around. I'm trying a new tactic. It's like, for once, I think, especially, I've always said, in that back core unit, between the centre-backs and the keeper, you've got to have some consistency. Yeah. When it's going right, when it's going wrong, you've got to stick with it. And I feel like he's done that, and now he's getting some rewards out of it. And some of your new signings as well. Boy, Ziyech, I think he's had a nice little week.
And you might have seen it. He was always the one I've been waiting for, just because of that bit of magic with the breaking of the line or just creating something. His creativity is second to none. And 100%. When you have that in your team, especially in a team where we're doing lots of passes and we're not going forward, it just makes a lot of a difference. He's one of them people where if he's trying stuff and it's not coming off, I don't mind, because I know if it goes right, it's amazing. He's not forcing it. He's actually trying to do proactive, beautiful football stuff. So
he's the missing link in that front line. I thought had speed, you had strength, you had every type. But that X factor player who can create something out of nothing, I don't think you have.
I liked this, but and again, what I don't want to look too much into is I think we were in a way, Lampard realized that he had to address the defensive stuff. We're seeing the clean sheets now. But like I said, we have to build upon that. We're seeing that we're starting to score more goals. What I will have to say is the caveat here. We're playing a Burnley side that made no signings. We had our midweek
still
game.
Still haven't won, have they?
Yeah, midweek game against Champions League opposition, who are 11th in the Russian League. This has come at a good time for us. So Lampard has to, you know, make sure the defence is not keeping clean sheets. Get the goals, feel good, get the good feel factor.
Yeah.
And then make sure we can build upon that.
Pre-game, I'll be honest with you. I thought that was going to kill you because I was thinking you've just come from Russia and you're playing Burnley. And considering how they played against us on Monday, I thought you're going to be in for a rough day. But then
Burnley haven't been great. Made it look too easy, bro. Again, you have to take advantage of these games. And the key thing for me now is we mentioned about Ole being reactive. We've seen this 4-3-3 twice or three times now. It seems to work.
Is that the one?
For me, if that's going to be... What I said at the beginning of the season.
What, 4-2? What was it?
4-3-3 he's playing, basically.
No, it's basically 4-3-3, Kante alone and two other people. My thing is, if you're going to do something and stick to your guns, go for it. But you can't do this thing where it's like one week it's this, one week it's that. Don't get me wrong, I understand changing your tactics for different moments, but you have to have a game plan. If you don't have a game plan, there's no point doing anything else because it's just going to come helter-skelter and everything. The one thing I did like about this performance in particular, and it's, I've mentioned the last few weeks, we've not managed to get the ball quick enough. Mm-hmm. We pass it, no link.
Yeah.
I think, like I said a while ago that if you were to throw someone out and put Mason Mount in his position and it worked, no one can argue with you. No one can fault you because you've done something and it's going to wreck. It's when you're putting players out of position and taking other players out of their natural position to accommodate someone else that doesn't want to be there, it looks a bit funny in the light. So for that, credit, I'm not going to make the mistake I made last year, which was every little decision that Frank does, oh, this is amazing. No, this is what you're expected to do now.
Well, like Zuma.
Your hair, Burnley. No, this is what you're expected to do. I'm happy with the results. I'm happy with the clean sheets because, again, you're addressing it. Big up Mendy as well. Zuma made a crazy mistake, but you have a goalkeeper that's there to clean it up. That's the difference it makes, you know. When we're making the mistakes before, you know when the ball went, I can't remember what it did, but it was dumb, and then Mendy made the save. Normally, if that's Kepa, it's a goal.
What? I can't remember.
When he tried to do the back pass and he got in front of him.
Yeah.
He got in front of him.
Yeah. And then Mendy makes a save. If that's Kepa now, I'll be honest. I don't know.
With Chelsea, with Chelsea, what's one thing that is good is that you're getting apparent Thiago Silva quality doing what he needs to do.
Yeah.
You guys are defending well, and that's what he needs to address, Lampard. But I do think Chelsea fans are getting a bit excited about what is going on. I mean, Burnley are the worst team in the Premier League.
No, but that's what I'm saying. Like, the last two games, right now, for where we are, those are good games. So just make sure you do what you're doing.
Yeah.
Make sure that you can continue having these clean sheets, but it's a foundation to build upon.
Yeah, it's a foundation.
If we had really bad performances in these two games, you'd be looking at this and going, wow, you know what?
But I feel I'm like not Chelsea
saying that
this
is a turning of a corner. I'm saying this is now, in this Premier League right now, the top team have conceded the most goals in the league. The team that are second have only just won their first game at home. Mm. All of the other wins were away. This league this year is a weird league.
That's where I'm thinking this is where Chelsea could take advantage.
So my thing is, if you're
taking... anyone can.
When we're talking about taking advantage, for me, taking advantage is not about showing initiative and going on these 4-0s and whatnot.
No,
it's
but
about
I
making sure that you're a steady ship. And a steady ship means that, okay, you know what? Game to game, you're just getting by. You're just doing what you need to do. Because really and truly, if Liverpool are top of the league and they've conceded the most goals, that tells you, hold on, this is weird.
It's up for grabs.
This is a weird time playing football. We've said that the no influence of fans. We know that games are coming thick and fast. We know that players are getting injured. So therefore, each week, you're having to chop and change who's played in your systems and everything. So consistency at a level is what's going to be the real game changer.
It's not even just about consistency, it's a race on who's going to be consistent
first.
Of
course,
that's
we've mentioned good coaches and everything before. That's why some of these teams that have the good coach, like the Bielsa and everything, it'll be interesting to see them because they could lose a star man. But because that man coming in knows what to do, it's plug and play. You can continue and do what you need to do. You understand? With the other teams, like, I don't know what's going to happen now
for me, but the thing is, look, this is what... But I said there should be no excuse for Chelsea not to title charge. You signed 6 players. You've got depth in your squad. Pulisic came out. Okay, why not you start? Like, I don't want to hear none... Like,
of course.
Not with you, but I'm just saying, I don't want to... Like, you know, Chelsea fans are kind of making it like that you're some secret, like, underdogs. You're not really. Nah. Like, you guys splashed. You've got strength in depth. You've got quality in the team. You've got apparently the best midfielder I've ever seen or something because he played decent against Burnley. But but in all honesty though, like Ben said, you guys have got a good team and there should be no reason why Charles shouldn't title charge.
Facts,
when you look at your team, who you played against Brighton, as you said, everyone started. Chill, Burnley. Chilwell looks like he's been at Chelsea for how long?
He's done, I have to say, I've said it before.
You guys, everyone will hype about Ziyech and all that. He's been Chelsea's best signing so far, in my opinion.
Havertz is getting a lot of hype. Give it a couple more weeks, it'll be Ziyech,
bruv. Yeah, for me, I just think he's slotted in. He looks like he's been there. I'm not being funny though. Mount played well, right? Mount played really well. Yep. Kante played well. Everything went well in that game. But all I'm saying is, Burnley at the moment have zero wins, right? They have zero wins, and that's fact. Mm-hmm. They play a 4-4-2 for goodness sake. Kante had the whole of Turf Moor was his. Do you know what I mean? And people are like, yeah, see, this is what I mean. Play him as a six. But then when he was playing as a six, you guys said he's not a six. And now he played one good game against Burnley, against Ashley Westwood and these men. And now he's a six. Let's see what happens next week. Let's see what keeps going. That's all I'm saying. Like, people were at me talking about, what are you saying now?
Coming.
One go, after Burnley and Ashley Westwood?
Let's go back to what I said at the top of the show. In terms of football, a lot of fanatics look at the game in this with me.
Get sucked into the moment.
This is essentially a job. We have to look at stuff in totality. And the totality is Chelsea have not really defended well. We're finally getting back to clean sheets. We're playing opposition which is less than us. With our improvements and everything.
You have a consistent backline and you're using your depth.
Yeah, we're doing well. So now it's about, when I said it's the beginning of the season, stepping into the light. I need to see the continuation and building upon this, because staying the way we are right now won't be enough. We have to build upon this.
Yeah.
Like I said last week.
Who you got next?
We've got Rennes in the Champions League. And that's another thing that, thank you for actually reminding me. So our Champions League group is one of those things where it's not the hardest group. Therefore, ticking along will get us through. Chelsea should need to use these things to their advantage. We haven't got like games which you guys had where it's like, oh my gosh, this is a mad game. We've not really got that. Therefore, take along and do what you need to do. In the league, our running now is a bit decent. Do what you need to do. Find consistency.
I think Chelsea
with consistency is confidence. I think
Chelsea will be the team to go consistent, because you've got, as I said, you've got the team. The thing is, you've got players like people like Mount who can play in different positions, and that also helps with your squad depth. You had Mount playing a number eight, right? Which he'll probably say is his best position.
He had a good game.
And then you can alternate between like the Reece James and Aspie.
I'm happy with how
Reece James is playing lately. Yeah. He's growing game by game.
Goodbye to Kovacic, he's not getting back in that team.
You've got to fight for it.
One, there's that. But two, again, this then comes down to the manager, because for me, you can't be like what Ole's done and said, okay, this is the golden carrot, I'm going to use this. Oh, it's not working, let me change this now. Because at the end of the day, you don't get consistency with that. If Lampard stuck to a game plan and stuck to a thing and said, you know, even what happens, I'm just going to shift people around and do that. You can't fool him, because then it's like, you know what, you're trying something.
Do you think he should stick with 4-3-3 now, moving forward?
For me, if
it's worked in this short term, the form is right, the clean sheets are coming.
He's only played one game, 4-3-3, by the way.
Yeah.
No, he's moved it. No, he's moved to it within a game. He started with it for a whole game once. My thing is, if you're confident with it, if this is what you want to do, and you're going to put players in the right position to do it, go for it. I can't fault you on that, because you've put your leg out and done it. My thing is, don't go and play a next team now and then say, you know what, let's go five here and then do this. Because what was the point of what you've done before? Stick to your guns.
What would be your preferred shape?
I've said for a while, we need to move the ball quicker in midfield. We have to, because it kills our offense. In terms of our forward three, I know that can get goals, but we need to get the ball quicker now. If you're playing a situation where you have a midfielder that can move the ball quickly like Mount does, I won't be angry at that. Accommodate him as you will. I can't be mad at that. Because the thing is,
they won't be mad at it now until they scapegoat.
No.
Mount was last season's scapegoat.
Don't do this again. I'm not part of the scapegoat.
That's all I'm saying.
If there's a situation where you want to play him and you know he can move the ball forward in that position, great. If you want Kovacic to do it, I'm not dribbling it, great. But you have to assess your situation and say, okay, that is where we're lacking. We don't move the ball quick enough. We'll pop it around and it never goes forward.
I thought the way he was spraying it around.
He was spraying it around. Look, they were saying, like Chelsea
but
fans,
again, it's
they,
Burnley.
They
again,
get on,
it's
exactly.
Burnley.
You never told us what you preferred.
I asked for a formation. I'll go 4-3-3.
So that's a 4-3-3.
I'll go 4-3-3,
I think Chelsea can, I don't, like,
but remember,
formations
are interchangeable. Formations are interchangeable, but I would go for 4-3-3, and I would make sure that, for me, you always just kind of have that one person behind the ball sweeping across midfield. That's my main thing. just always have someone there. Because like I said with the Jorginho and Kante thing in that game,
that
I don't
want to see both of them running. That needs to stop. Whatever, double pivot with Jorginho and Kante. But in my opinion,
didn't I say that last season? Anyway. In my opinion, in other games, the Kante six with Havertz just floating around doing whatever he wants is not always necessarily going
to
work out.
Havertz wants to twice lost guys, the ball in his own half as well, man.
It's all right, but I don't know about in the next game.
He needs to cut out. Every game so far, I think I've seen him lose the ball in dangerous areas.
Do you know what the funniest thing about Havertz so far is?
Say the Bundesliga, you know.
There's that, but the funniest thing about him so far this season is, what's impressed most is how industrious he is, that he gets around, he gets challenges and everything. But we bought you to kind of
do the other thing. Yeah. The thing is, I don't want Chelsea fans, though, at the same time, to think he's the Messiah because you lot paid that money. He's a good player.
If that happens, it's the club's fault.
Your squad right now is talented enough for him to settle in. You lot still don't need him to drag you and win you games yet. I think this season, your team is more than stacked. Like you said, Pulisic got injured before kickoff. Werner came in quick time, scored his goal. Safe,
mate. Just relax in January. Just come back towards
like
March.
Chol don't even get a look at
where we
again,
need to go.
Like we said,
honestly, like you guys have got enough depth.
But like we said, and the key thing is, any Chelsea fans watching this or not, it's very important not to start getting carried away because you've seen 3-0, 4-0.
Title charge. All right, let's go.
But they know it deep down. They think they know they're good enough for a title job. They're just trying to act.
No. Listen, I'm just saying, in terms of get your foundation right.
Liverpool,
get your foundation right.
Who was they playing the other day? They were struggling as well, was it? Till the second half.
Who?
They needed a penalty to save them.
Who? Chelsea? No, Liverpool. Playing Liverpool. Like, I don't know.
One thing I wanted to say, you know the game that you lot are playing at Arsenal? You know the only difference in that game is if the Maguire penalty incident goes a different way?
Pretty much.
That was the only difference.
Yeah, pretty. But they created more than you guys.
In terms of when you look at things black and white, if we have that penalty, it's 1-0.
Yeah, pretty much.
But
nah, you lot
that's my thoughts on that. Quickly, it wouldn't be right if we didn't touch on G-Biz and we didn't touch on your midweek performance. How do you feel about the
which
mentality?
One?
Huh? You see
which
how one? They want to touch on their midweek, but they don't want to touch on Rashford's midweek.
Who's saying agendas?
You see this podcast,
we need to
boy.
Feed Rashford out here.
Listen, you see this podcast, boy. I ain't gonna say nothing, boy.
You want to touch on Rashford?
I don't need to say because it's dead now.
We're going into Champions League review shortly.
Champions League review.
Yeah. So before we go into Champions League review, I just want to finish with Spurs.
Who's the top scorer in the Champions League? I actually don't know.
Neither do I.
No, honestly, check.
Is it Rashford?
What?
Was it?
I don't
with
know
how many goals?
Can you check?
With how many goals?
Just check. I don't know. Let's check.
Is it four?
Let's just check. Right. Let's just right, check.
Cool.
I don't.
Let's carry
I don't
on the show.
Know. Can we
let's
check
carry
me?
On the show.
I don't. I might be wrong. You know, there might be someone with five
it's four,
or something.
It's four.
Is it? So who's the top goal scorer?
Four. It's Rashford. Yeah.
He's number two.
Oh, I see.
Who? CEO.
Who's that? Who?
Coleman. You know this.
Oh. But who's? Wait. Can you just say who's first again?
It's Rashford. Marcus Rashford.
Oh, okay. And who's the teams that we played?
PSG.
Yeah, and that where did they finish last season?
Can you get to the fucking point, lad?
Where did they finish last season?
Finishing what? In Champions League?
Yeah.
They were
losers.
Yeah.
They were losers.
So that means they were the second best team
they
in the
were
whole
losers.
Tournament. And then what about Leipzig?
You mean the COVID tournament where there's one leg?
Can you just answer?
The COVID tournament where there's one leg?
Where did Leipzig finish?
What, the COVID tournament? They finished semi-finals in the COVID tournament.
Semi-final? So if Rashford's got four goals against the team that finished second and the team that finished third or fourth.
You truly believe PSG are the second best team in Europe?
Proof's in the puds, mate.
You're a piece of shit, you know that.
Proof's in the puds.
You think Leipzig's the fourth best team in Europe?
No, PSG.
Proof's in the puds.
PSG,
I don't know.
PSG can...
That's what I don't really need to say. Because we're talking about Champions, that's fine. All I've got to say, so we got the current top scorer. Fair enough.
Bayern and Liverpool.
We move.
Talk to us about
Liverpool.
Yeah.
Go on, talk to us about Spurs.
Liverpool, the second best team in Europe.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'll give it to them.
The teams are
definitely ahead of PSG.
COVID is
definitely ahead of PSG.
I can't
bottle jobs.
Now PSG suck.
PSG bottle jobs.
On whatever the vibe is.
Mm. Yeah. Now PSG suck. Mbappe don't see
the Maracanã in his headphones.
Can't be a vibes team, man.
No, you can't be a vibes team.
They're FIFA 21. That's what they are, bro. They're good for FIFA, and that's it.
Kit's nasty, but
speak about you boys.
Address it.
Antwerp, bro. Disgusting. What can I say? Like. Subs come in. I mean, what did he make? 9 changes, I think it was. And
made 4 subs at half time, right?
There's a lot of players. I'm just glad they're showing their true colours.
Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
What's your thoughts on Jose Mourinho's Instagram account?
One of the best things, I think, to hit the internet this year.
Mr.
Like, it is what it is, you know what I mean? Like, my manager's got a bit of personality, you know what I mean? And you know what? It gives him another avenue to express himself. That's
Jose's
what I like.
Thinking about his manager's career.
Feet, man. So,
Jose's uncle. He thinks he's at home, bro. He sees his toes in his role, bro. Flipping out. Yeah, but he's trying to be a superstar. But anyway, go on.
But I thought poor game in all. I thought there was no, maybe Vinicius, maybe in the first half, but I thought every single player had a shocker. And I think the players that came off at halftime, rightfully so. I think Lo Celso, I think Ali, all poor.
What do you think of Lo Celso? Is he...
Lo Celso, here's my thing. I think last season, a lot of people were getting caught up in looking at his stats, and I thought he was affecting games. Mm. I think he's a quality player on the ball. He brings something to our midfield. Mm. Is he now, am I going to say he's going to be a world-class player and one of the best? No. But I think he's a quality player to have in our midfield, even as depth. If he eventually becomes
who
that,
starts at the moment, Sissoko and Dembele.
Sissoko and Dembele and Højbjerg seem to be the option. I haven't seen Lo Celso and Dom and Højbjerg start yet,
that's
which is
much,
what every
that's overkill for Jose.
That's like, oh, like,
I'm giving
too
you
much freedom.
Relax.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, and man, that's what it is.
What do you think about Thingy
poor,
as well?
Poor.
The situation, because you ain't even touched on it. We've talked about it privately, but what do you think about the situation with Dele Alli in terms of? It's very reminiscent into what happened with United and with Martial and Rashford.
No.
It is. Because, listen, let me tell you why it's reminiscent. Let me tell you why it's reminiscent. Because we know Jose was sending for Ali. Come on.
Yeah.
We know it was directly. It was Ali's the guy he's talking about, right? Jose has basically said that Ali's not my guy. You know what I mean? He came out and said, now, you know, this is why he's... He actually basically said the exact same thing with Rashford.
Do you
and
know
thing.
What the difference is?
Wait, bro.
Go on.
It's, with Rashford and thing, he said, this is why Lukaku always plays when he did it. Rashford has turned the other corner. Come on, we got to admit.
Yeah,
since
Jose's
turned the other corner. Do you think there's a possibility of that with Ali? You know, I personally don't think Ali's that.
This is the thing. Yeah.
What do you think?
What was different for me about that situation is when Jose initially came in, Ali was one of his guys. Mm-hmm. When he came in, he took him under his wing and said, yo, where's the real Ali? And every press conference was hyping on like, we're going to get him. We're going to bring him back. And I think once that kind of initial burst of form came and he saw that it faded, he was like, all right, yeah, cool. You don't want to. And in that time as well, you got to take into account, Ndombele went from star man
zero
getting kicked
hero.
Out halfway through Burnley to full circle now last hero. Week. He's like, midweek, he was like, yo, need we him. Missed Ndombele. Yeah. I need him. When I see those two pictures from, you went from the guy, to, and this guy is now favored. Yeah. That tells me it's something to do with you.
Yeah,
and with Dele Alli, we've seen it too often. And one thing we also said as well, previous years, the position he played in. He doesn't have that position to himself anymore now. It's not a case of, we need you and Kane to link up.
Can I chime
you've
in
seen
though?
Son and Kane's link up.
Yeah. So,
that's history
now.
And when you're going back almost two seasons back, touching on, we saw these moments of Alli. It's like, how much longer can you keep basking on post-glory? It's like, now you're almost at...
He was
at a dangerous point. Exactly.
24?
You're 23, turning 24 now. Mm. It's like you're almost becoming almost into that Lingard range where it's like, ooh, if you don't start pushing on in the next year or two, that's why me personally, I said we should have got rid of him last summer. I feel like he still had value then. I feel like we could have got maximum for him, if that makes sense. And he can possibly still play for a decent club. Now, if he leaves, his stock's at an all-time low.
Do you think his money that you can generate for him is enough to risk selling him? Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Is 40 million that much money to, instead of maybe he can turn the corner?
I think if it depends. It depends.
Nothing,
it depends
like...
if you're smart. Because for example, we signed Højbjerg for 15 million. Look at the difference he's made in our midfield. Absolutely brilliant. And I thought, Dele Alli, I think if we get rid of him, 40 million, I think we can get another foreign talent.
Do you know the issue? Do you know the issue?
Bro,
issue with
this man, this sounds a Højbjerg hater, isn't it?
Do you know the issue with the Dele Alli thing is, right? We said it a while ago that we realized that he's not a cam, he's a second striker, because a cam has this sort of creative element to the game in that sort of position. Your whole onus is creating opportunities for those in front of you or your wingers. He's a second striker.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at what Harry Kane's doing this season with goals and assists,
false nine, baby.
You don't need Dele Alli. Like, without Dele Alli even having to come on the pitch, you look at that pitch and say, hold on. Kane's not having to run.
Bro, his Kane's average position there. Is behind
people,
the wingers.
People are going in front of Kane. Why do I then need to accommodate Dele Alli into this? Before it was...
But before, it was because Ali would run beyond Kane.
Exactly, but now...
But now, is
you've
I don't
got
know,
Son
like,
there,
I don't
and
know.
For
before
me...
Before it was like Kane would drop in.
But it was more like a 4-2-3-1. Yeah. I feel like now it's like Son is directly, his role
exactly.
is to run in behind. Yeah. But Son is almost like a left striker.
Yeah.
That's
go.
What he is.
So now, do you don't
day,
need
man.
Him. And that... Modern day. But bro. that was our fear for him because we said you can't play centre mid. Mm. You're not doing this creative thing in the point in CAM. I haven't seen you play centre forward. Mm. So realistically,
and that's the thing.
If you don't adjust,
I think he's a striker. I think Dele Alli's a striker. So,
but this
fam.
Is the thing, right?
Here's the thing.
It's been highlighted here, but you ever have to come out and say that?
We say Forsyth. Did we not have Son and Kane out last year? He had the chance to play up front, and he wasn't scoring.
No.
He had his chance to play up front, and then they went, "Now we'd rather have Mora."
You're raising a good point. Again, you look at his attributes. You look at how he scored goals in the past. You look at his movement in the box, you'd think, you know what, he can do that. So, personally, I don't even think it's a Spurs thing. He has to decide in his career now, what do I do? Because really and truly, mm-hmm. how many teams Facts. Are going to accommodate that position he's playing for Spurs? None. No teams are coming. No teams are going
to
play.
That's why he can't play for
him. He's now at a stage here where he even needs to settle for, I'm going to become a squad player and battle for my spot back. Or I actually need to go on and, if you still want to be an England international, whatever it is, you need to leave the club.
I honestly think, like, I mean, I look at play. You look at players.
You're getting subbed off Europa games.
You look at players that are doing well. Like, you got strikers in the Premier League for some of these lower teams that get goals and stuff. I genuinely think if Dele Alli moved a little bit lower and played up front, he'll bang goals. I think he can head up. He can head up pretty decently. He can score. He's a quality finisher.
His hold up
he's
player a is
good,
not the greatest.
Yeah, that's the only thing. He's a good runner. Playing as a striker and coming from striker to linking up deeper will be more kind of
suited
like a
how long before people are annoyed by his flick-ons.
You know what I'm trying to say? I think he's got the attributes.
But again,
he's not creative enough to play as a cam. As we said,
can't
and
play
he's not.
Mid.
He's.
I don't
I,
think
for
he's
me, I
clinical
don't think
enough to play up front.
Secure enough to play centre mid.
No, no. That's but what I will say is a lot of people chime in and say early on in his career he played centre mid. What you have to remember is that's MK Dons. This is Premier League.
Ox played centre mid for Southampton.
It's very different.
I think he saw him and said, "Yo, it's Premier
different.
League level. I don't really know." And since then he's been at Liverpool a bench sub player.
And to be fair, right. Players recreate themselves all the time. This is not a slight on him. It's Facts. Just that sometimes you have to...
Too early to recreate yourself.
You
recreate
sometimes,
yourself when you're in, you know what I mean? You're like
no,
28.
But when you're in
recreate
this
yourself at 23?
But to recreate yourself from a cam to a centre mid, especially when your club has been calling for it over the last year or so, when we didn't have Ndombele's creativity, when Lo Celso was still settling in, Alli could have made that spot his own and said, nah, I'm still here. For me, he refused to... kind of evolve and become that player. And
from
a
that,
lot,
from
a
that,
lot
you,
of these failings,
you,
I feel like are
that,
his own fault. That's my issue.
And then the thing is, so if we say that, then we have to assess this.
You got
to
remember, 12 months ago, I was saying I preferred Alli over Dybala.
Yeah.
So like for me to come full circle, this is how much I was defending Alli is what I'm saying. This is how much I was defending Alli. I was like, yo, I can still see there's something there for him. But
you know how you tried to say Dybala. Who's the other guy you said that you would prefer Alli?
No, it was only Dybala. Don't try throwing another name.
Remind us.
Who are you going to throw in?
Remind us.
Look at this fraud.
Remind
Look
us.
At his face.
I've actually forgotten. Remember.
Of course, because he's going to lie. Go on,
you
lie. Said
you didn't prefer Alli over Jack Grealish.
Oh, Jack Grealish.
There was a time that wasn't
a comparison. Come
no,
on,
it
man.
It was.
You was making that comparison when Jack was coming up in the championship.
Foresight. Foresight.
We don't claim foresight.
Foresight
no.
or
I call
no
it how
sight.
I see it.
Nah.
I call
foresight
it how I see
or
it.
No sight.
I wait till it happens, then I'm like, all right.
Nah,
bro. I call it like I see it. I don't do this. Telekinesis. I leave that to you, man.
The
crystal ball thing, I leave that to you, man.
It's funny though, yeah, because remember when people were saying, oh, Grealish centre mid? In fact, we don't have to go into that.
Listen, for me, I agree with you in terms of, I do think, because that, even though it's just the documentary, that all or nothing thing, Alli's a bit of a joke, man, in the way he acts. You know what I'm trying
it's
to say?
Demeaning,
if it's
bro.
Going well, when it's going well, even Daniel Levy turned around and was like, I don't know what's happened to him. 2 years ago, he was up here. Now he's like, they don't even know what's going on. Jose Mourinho pinpointed it to, you're not a good trainer. And I've always said, this is the aspect where we can't really talk on if we're not
in the room.
The behind
we're
the
not
scenes.
In the room. I can't turn around and say, Dele Alli's a bad trainer. But if Jose Mourinho is going to come on a documentary and say, Dele Alli's a bad trainer, then I'm going to take his word for it.
Yeah.
It seems if you're not a good trainer, Jose is gonna not going to like you. And if you're not going to train, you're not going to improve yourself.
Yeah.
And at this rate, it's declining. How is turned from Dele Alli looking like, whoa, is this guy might be the key to England doing decent in the World Cup to not even call up?
Ward out of Prowse, the squad completely.
Winks, Every man is getting called up, and Dele Alli's not even included. He's in the Lingard position.
Yeah.
We don't even care about him no more. Lingard, Smalling. You know them man? They're just Bingo's, them lighties. The forgotten lighties.
Yeah.
Flipping hell, bro.
That's what he's becoming. Nah, listen. Hey, bag the goal today, bro. Respect Callum Wilson.
He's got two today, bro. When you play like a niche position, you ever have to be so good here that your team accommodates you, or if you're not in form and you're not good, you're forgotten about. It's not like conventional positions where it's like, oh, I'm going to put you in. When you're a niche guy, your game has to be there.
I think it's so bad that, like Thomas Muller.
Yeah.
Like, yes. Thomas Muller, Antoine Griezmann. Look what's happened to him now that he's having to go right wing. He's struggling. When you have a player like that, but then again, as I'm saying, Muller's never reinvented himself. He's Thomas Muller.
Wait.
Assist.
Respect Muller, bruv. Muller's gone from being a striker to a cam to a right winger.
You're not getting what I'm saying.
I'm saying he's played multiple positions and mastered it, bruv. But this year, he's actually turned into a creator for the first time in his career.
You're not getting what I'm saying. I'm saying he's always, no matter what, when you're talking about a nine...
You're talking about the Space Invader thing.
Bro, no. What?
God.
When you're talking about... I don't know what he's about. When you're talking about a nine, like back in the day, because Muller would score goals, he's always been a top player.
Yeah.
But when you talk about a nine, you didn't include Muller. Because when you talk about a cam, you never include Muller. Right winger, you did.
I always include him as a right winger.
I know what you're trying to say in terms of Muller's conversation.
So when you're talking about
natural position, you don't know which one.
This is what I mean. You would always just be like, Muller's just Muller.
Yeah.
You would never be. Are you guys trying to? Okay, you man are trying to tell me.
He's not a right winger.
No.
But you're not getting what I'm saying. Listen, are you trying to tell me? Wait, let me like this. Are you trying to tell me when you were talking about back in the day about who's the best winger, Bale?
No, I get what you're saying. He never had natural position.
Muller always stood by himself. And it was like, Muller is sick and he was always the standard. And the thing is, because he was always so sick, Muller. You'd be talking about centre forwards and you'd be like, he's not really a centre forward, but I rate him. Because his standard was there.
Yeah,
and the thing is, when you're a niche person, you have to be there. Because the thing is, not every team can accommodate for you.
Facts.
So, boy, as soon as that Bobby Firmino now, the second that he's not looking shiny Liverpool in the light and everything, is that,
bro, Jota?
He's not centre forward, he's not this, is that that?
Perfect signing. Like,
Jota?
So you get what I'm saying? If you're a niche player,
he's warming.
Your levels constantly have to be at a level where no one can debate your significance to your team. Once your significance is debated, to a certain extent, I'm not going to throw Kante in this, but it's like how everyone's like, Kante's not a DM, Kante's a DM, Kante plays in two, Kante's playing not. As soon as the impact goes, people start going, oh, what is he actually? When you play these sort of positions where it's not stapled in stone,
When you have a player, I agree with you, and I'm saying it, I always saw Griezmann, Ali, Muller, I always saw them as players where I didn't really know where to define them, and Griezmann and Ali...
They've been moved out and they're struggling.
Muller, but you see Muller because he's got that
mentality.
Do you think that just basically the way football tactics has happened, the game has moved past them because SSs aren't really in the game?
Not only that, SSs, natural number 10s are barely even there. But it's not only that, it's obviously the position of either SS or 10, right? Yeah. It's a dying position in the game. Yeah. And it's just the fact the 10s who were 10s. Here we had David Silvers and all that. He had to move into centre midfielder. Coutinho, centre midfield.
James.
No disrespect to him. He plays for Everton for a reason now. Because he couldn't adapt to that 10. He said it himself to Rio Ferdinand. The 10s are going. I've got to adapt. Now he's playing as this kind of right winger. And he's doing well at Everton. Isco. He's got SOS for him at the moment.
Struggling.
He can't
move like from Hagrid.
The 10 has gone. So yeah, that is true.
Bro, tell me about
the 10 has gone because in that Champions League runs, he was quality as a centre midfielder, but maybe he can't sustain it. And look, he's now the 10 is disappearing and so is that SS role. And some people need to adapt. That's just football, isn't it?
You're going to have to adapt. That's the thing.
We tried to play him out wide as well, Dele Alli. We tried the left wing team and it didn't work.
This is also why I think Foden, why Pep still doesn't start Foden every game. I think he sees him as a 10, but he's like, can I put you centre mid? I don't know, but I can't put you right wing.
You're too light.
I still think he's a bit confused about where to put him. That's why sometimes Foden...
He'll play him on the left wing.
Next game's on the bench. You're like, what? I don't know. That was weird.
That was weird.
Old school conventional right mid, left mid. Can't do that anymore. Even like the whole
days of
get down the byline and just whip it.
Like those things have gone. So them sort of players had to then adjust to different things. And like, don't get me wrong, the game moves, But if
that's how football is, man. The game
that's how football is. But you have to find where's next. You have to find where's next. Yeah, like, is it centre mid? Soon,
maybe
striker.
Maybe people will be doing sweeper again.
Boy,
Beckham by a days.
remember
the me.
Hey, hold on. Yeah. How are you gonna touch on my L but not touch on my W, bruv?
Oh, Neil,
my Gareth Bale coming home. The homecoming. That's my champ of the week, baby.
Talk to us about
the homecoming, baby. The assist from Sergio. Straight from Madrid.
To Madrid,
bro.
Yeah.
I love to see it, man. That's exactly what we signed up
for. That's your
when we're struggling, when we're needing that kind of X factor to come on.
That's your champ of the week. Yeah. Who's yours?
Champ of the week, baby.
Champ of the week.
I've got two this week.
My champ of the week is Jack Grealish.
Not Rashford, no?
After
the midweek shenanigans, came on as a sub.
How many? You
were saying we were ignoring him, now you're ignoring him.
I'm talking about Grealish, but I'll tell you my reasons. But Rashford,
every week is Grealish, man.
Rashford is the champ of life. He's not champion of the week. He's champion of life at the
champ
moment.
Champion of the season.
He's as I said, Monday, Boris Johnson, where are you? Come outside. Tuesday, who wants to be fed? Wednesday, Leipzig, hat trick. Do you know what I mean? You gotta give him.
He's hacking it in everywhere.
Yeah, obviously Arsenal not a good game, but you gotta give him the champ of
Gabriel
life. But the reason why I'm saying Jack Grealish is because. Have you guys I'm being honest now. Like, have you guys seen a carry job like this, bro? This is getting ridiculous. Jack Grealish carries this team. And you know what's mad? Carry jobs are from strikers usually. Danny Ings carries Southampton more time.
Well, you ain't gonna give Ward-Prowse his flowers now.
Are you trying to tell me last season Danny Ings did not carry them all season?
But this season Ward-Prowse is
still doing
right?
his thing though. Yeah, obviously he's doing all right now, but he still does his thing. Danny Ings, but you see it most time when you talk about carry job. People talk about Tevez at West Ham. People talk about Defoe at Sunderland. People talk about Danny Ings at Southampton.
Yeah.
Who else is there? Other carry jobs.
Gerrard was a carry job.
Of course, that's why he's one of the greats, though.
You can carry jobs.
How many midfielders do you see? But Gerrard is Liverpool is still one of the best teams in the league. Even without Gerrard, they'll still be one of the best teams in the league.
Go on, finish the pun. And
Jack Grealish, you haven't seen a carry job for a team so poor like what Jack Grealish is doing. In my opinion, you don't see it.
Let me ask you
don't
question,
see it. Was it 4-0 down?
We kill me.
This guy
took Villarreal to a semi-final. Respect it, bro.
Villarreal
were nobodies. When Riquelme touched scene, he said, "Let me take you to the promised land."
Villarreal are Aston Villa level, yeah.
Y'all ain't never seen this.
They are the real Villa.
He said, "Europe, let me take you past the group stage."
Times good.
Riquelme Arsenal back then.
You men are comparing Villarreal.
And then they got knocked out by penalty. Did they not get knocked out by penalties as well?
You guys are just. Hey, listen, the session.
Respect Riquelme. The history of Riquelme.
One of the best tens that you've ever seen,
mate. What I will say about the Grealish ring is, like, we've known his talent. He's shown his talent now.
I don't know if you men have known his talent, but we move. I don't know. I remember you men banging on about Madison over Grealish. I remember this, but we move.
He's
like,
Madison.
Anyway, you
didn't
know his talent.
I don't know. You
never watched Championship, bro. I don't know. Everton fans are coming here to talk rubbish.
I don't know, man.
Everton fans coming here to chat rubbish, fam. Do you watch Championship? Man, am I living off my Sky subscription? I'm talking rubbish, man. Get out of there, man. Don't get a day job, bro. Anyway, as I was saying, flipping
Matty Cash, yeah? Bandwagon.
Matty Cash is decent, man.
Leave him.
He's getting killed today.
Man, am I sick.
I want to hear your shout first, and then I want to hear him jump.
You're sick, man.
You're always a secondary.
Go and get your Sky subscription, bro. Come off my Sky subscription. Anyway, flipping as I was saying, now we look at all of this year. What happens next him? Because he did sign that bumper deal now. So what happens next now?
I'm hoping that in that contract, there's some form of gentleman clause where it's like, if a big team comes, that's what a lot of people do. I don't think Zaha did it, but I'm hoping there's some form. That's the only thing I can hope for.
Wait,
if there's like, when you sign a new deal, there's like a gentleman clause.
You just signed a death row contract at Villa.
Yeah. Who knows, man?
So you ain't getting nowhere, bro.
Play football, bro. Some guys aren't.
He's going to become them club man. I'm Villa till I die.
I've got two champs here. My first one's Ibra.
Probably got punched in the head for them, man. You know,
39 and still schooling in Syria.
Big Zlat.
Yeah. And my second
don't
one
talk
is
on Zlatan ever again.
My second
one did a whole segment of fraud for Zlatan.
Hey,
my second big one.
And guess what? I watched that video today.
Love it.
I told no opinions, all facts. You can go check up on the Stoppage Time page.
Update it.
It was all Champions League and international related. It was all Champions League and international related. He ain't turned up in the big time. Let's just appreciate his league, what he's doing in Syria. He's a pensioner. He's doing his thing. Broke COVID.
Because what he's doing is mad. Second one is CR. He's 14 goals from becoming the top goal scorer of all time.
The GOAT.
14 goals away.
14 goals away from becoming the official top goal scorer.
More than Pele.
More than Pele. Pele counts goals. The fucking Pele. Garden goals.
Come outside,
because fucking...
Pele was scoring against war veterans. Pele was scoring against
Miners.
Scoring
14 goals. You know, we laugh at the MLS honestly. Now. He was playing in the MLS 70s.
Bro.
Imagine the standard.
Bro, flipping... I don't know, he was probably playing against Elgin Baylor and that. He was probably playing against some of the NBA... Yeah, he was probably playing against... he was playing against Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and that. I don't know who...
I said Harlem Globetrotters.
Who were playing then? Who was he playing against?
I don't know.
Did the Lakers play
football? I don't know, bro. Franz Beckenbauer and friends.
I heard Wilt was a great athlete. He must have been playing against them, man.
Bro,
I don't know.
I'm telling you.
Man goes to him. He came back from COVID. He's killing it.
Respect CR, bro.
Shout out to Jovino. Man went to Italy and started scoring braces against everyone.
Who's he playing for now? Genoa or something?
Is it Parma?
Parma,
yeah,
Parma wasn't
scoring
it? Yeah.
Braces against everyone.
Fucking hell, bro.
Everyone. So,
the
yeah,
revival of that hairline.
The first two. My criminal. I think there's only one criminal this week.
And you ask me my champion.
We don't know
you.
We
don't know you.
Who are you? You don't get to say champion.
Yeah, yeah, we.
Can I say water?
No, time's going. Criminal of the week.
When you come to the
front. Nahiki Wells is my. Or whatever he pronounced his name.
Naki Wells.
Yeah, he's my criminal.
3-1 down, dinking penalties, brother.
Criminal.
Absolute duddery. Where is that shit emoji, bro? We need that.
If none of his teammates...
Because that was...
Lock him up. If none of his teammates scrapped him in there...
You got to punch him up.
Then football's gone.
Bro, it's a must.
You understand? You have the chance to get some sort of...
You know when you... know he was meant to score, pick up the ball.
Let's go.
It's still 0-0 left.
He's chipping.
Bro, it went on target. It just
over the bar. My goodness.
No
to Tim
finesse.
Krul as well.
No.
The keeper, the
penalty
goat.
Connoisseur.
Oh my gosh. Penalty goat. Who's my criminal? Who's your criminal?
I don't even have a criminal.
I mean...
Listen, that's...
Mine's got to be just Ollie. It's just got to be Ollie. Default, he could be it every week, to be honest.
No,
he's been it a few times.
You know who's becoming a criminal, but I won't name him just yet.
Who?
Matt Doherty.
Got
our eyes.
Standing on his own guys, you know?
Saying.
Oh!
Hey, listen.
Is he
guy's
ball,
not
yeah?
a right back.
Yeah,
that's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's a wing back ting, bro. No, I said it in the intro video. That's what I said. It'll be interesting to see how he looks in the back four.
You want Surge now, yeah?
This is why I'm saying, yo, we need to take our time. We need to review our options. Tanganga needs to come back. Hey, don't worry. We'll watch
it. Do you know, actually, do you know what? I'm going to give my criminal of the week, yeah? I'm going to give my criminal of the week to TalkSport as an organization. I'm going to give it to them and the whole
okay.
company.
The clickbait.
Free
yeah,
smoke.
Yeah. Listen, it's too much now, bro.
It's too much.
The clickbait.
Jason Cundy, you need to relax.
Bro.
It's not every day say something that doesn't make sense.
This is what I'm saying. Jason
it's not
Cundy,
an outrage.
Wait, what are we doing? Are we doing the Rashford Neymar thing?
No, first we can talk about Rashford Neymar. He's just talking and I'm for some reason he's moving hot-headed. Calm down, mate, in that studio, mate. Calm. I don't know what's going on there.
There's no AC
that. The clickbait that they do. What was the one that they did? Agent don't can. Oh my
Shut
goodness!
Up.
Yeah, and they. Do you know what they said? They said can Villa win the Premier League? Like, it's getting too clickbait, and people talk about us. People talk about all these people like us who. I guess you don't have journalism qualifications and all this type of stuff.
But then, man,
but then you guys are click. No, wait, you guys are giving them guys attention. Oh my
Listen,
goodness, man.
All I would like to say is before we go,
Talk Sport,
overweight,
I'd like
organs.
To make this public statement. If you're still listening up until this point, hold tight you anyway. But listen, just because someone's reporting for a big organization that's fancy and shiny doesn't mean that their opinion is 100%. I'm starting to see a lot of stuff that we said last year come to light and people are like, that's true. Mm-hmm. We told you 2 years ago.
Another
told
criminal
you 2 years ago.
Is, God. Which is quite, it's kind of ironic, but it's Troy Deeney as well.
At the Sun.
Like,
talk
mate,
to me.
I don't rate the whole you're a footballer. You play
but
for
you're
Watford.
Out here doing chatty
play. Made how many? One appearance? I might be wrong, but when I last checked,
one
you
appearance
made
and it was 1 minute. I sent it to you.
One appearance and it was one minute. You're the captain of Watford Football Club.
Tom Cleverley's captain.
He was meant to be the captain, Troy Deeney, right?
But Tom Cleverley's captain.
Yeah, they criticize man like Pogba and all these guys for doing too much on social media and stuff. You've got a current professional footballer. That's
you've got
now,
two gigs.
Now
well, you've
got
a
jobs.
Gossip column.
Is that not
in the Sun?
Of all newspapers.
Is that not?
That's the worst bit
of
all.
Isn't that keep
of
the same
newspapers?
Energy?
What when the Metro giving up gigs or something else?
Bro,
even
it's
Standard.
Embarrassing.
Ain't that keep the same energy though?
It is.
That's what I'm going to say. That's very interesting. You criticize these guys for being too much on social media, but the captain of Watford isn't playing games out of choice. He's fit. he's just decided, bro, I'm going to be a journalist.
For me as well, it's just a fair enough. The Sun, the amount of times footballers call it out and say the amount of bullshit they spread.
And
in
he's meant to be the real guy.
You're meant to be like the real brother on the scene who's, nah, we're going to do this proper. It's, instead, you go on side with them.
And
stop
you know what's
that,
mad,
man.
After that's... when I had that conversation with Andre Gray, and he's talking about papers all the time. And we all know the main papers
the
are
come
Mark,
on,
so Mail
come on.
And the Sun. Mm. And your club captain. Mm? Yeah, boy.
Boy. Boy, it is what it is.
Lobato, we've come to the end. Yeah. Listen, that's another episode. Make sure you subscribe. Oh, make sure hey. Notifications are on. You gonna do the dance?
Look at this loser. Sit back down.
We're out of there, man. In a bit.